Artificial intelligence is designed by human and it's for humans. So we really care about that intersection of technology and humanity. So it's not technology as a guide, but instead technology as a tool that's being used amongst lots of other tools to address a problem, solve a real world problem. There are a multitude of real world problems. So we look at things in buckets. So we look at things like air quality and climate change and water and sewer and infrastructure, digital and physical, transportation, mobility. Throughout that, we have a thread of citizen engagement, thinking about, again, those humans, those people that live in cities. And we really think about, and then city operations. For example, we're working on a project taking technology to help address the issue of landslides. We had a really wet spring. We're going to have another wet spring here in Pittsburgh. And so it's using artificial intelligence combined with camera sensing from digital cameras and using those images to better predict and understand the likelihood of a landslide. So that informs infrastructure investments. It can help affect mobility. People, can, you know, me as a driver, I can get to where I need to go. We're very focused on the problem and using technology again as a tool. The path to connecting a technology to the solution is not straight. It's iterative. It takes communication skills. It takes, honestly, a human-to-human connection. Sometimes a municipality doesn't really understand the problem that it has. It understands the impact. We can't help a community if they don't know what their problems are, and we also can't help them if they haven't digitized some of their information. And so, for example, we had a project with the city of Pittsburgh, and there's over 20,000 commercial buildings in the city of Pittsburgh, and they have, I think it's 6 inspectors that need to inspect every one of those commercial buildings within 5 years. That's a daunting task for anybody. And so we were looking through our research and realizing that things like 911 calls, 311 calls, planning permits, all this kind of these buckets of information that oftentimes reside on someone's laptop, maybe in a spreadsheet, maybe it's on a piece of paper, but if you could digitize and marry and connect that information, you can find trends. And so we were able to create, again, an artificial intelligence model that used existing open data sources to help create a predictive model to determine the likelihood of a fire in one building in 1 year with 85% accuracy. It's the idea that before they looked at the way the inspectors would determine which buildings were most likely to have a fire, and they basically had no way of knowing. It was just, they just went through their list of buildings that they were going to inspect. But with this model, it helped give those inspectors an ability to determine the likelihood of a fire with 85% accuracy. And so at the end of the day, the best way to fight a fire is not to have a fire at all.